Weather Center.
Hi, everyone. Mostly sunny skies. More of a west breeze, 61 this afternoon. Mostly clear, 43 tonight. Tomorrow, mostly sunny. High of 63. Sunday, mostly sunny, 64. Staff meteorologist John Weatherby, Money Radio 1510 and 99.3 FM.
It is now 53 degrees with the Dow down 445 points at 15,934. S&P 500 down 51 at 1871. The NASDAQ down 151 points at 4464. Reporting for Money Radio, I'm Ken Morgan.
The views expressed on the following program do not necessarily reflect the views of Money Radio staff, management, or advertisers, and do not represent an offer to buy or sell any securities. Some interviews heard on this program may be sponsored by the participants. It's time for Health Futures with Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth. This is Arizona's only show dedicated to providing you with expert advice on how to live a longer, healthier, and happier life. To learn more, call 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Bob Roth.
Good afternoon. My name is Bob Roth, and you're listening to Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. We're a weekly show found right here on Money Radio 1510 AM, 99.3 FM, and on the World Wide Web at moneyradio1510.com. And we're coming at you from the Scottsdale Air Park Studios here at Money Radio, and we're proud to say we're in our third year on the air. And what our show is about how our aging adult population can live a healthier, happier life. And as many of you have listened in before, you know that our show is about bringing extraordinary guests on to really talk about healthcare and really the dynamics of healthcare and how it's changed. And if you're just listening into the show, my family and I are owners of a home care agency. We provide in-home care services, some refer to it as non-medical, enabling our aging adult population to be able to stay at home. And the secret to that success is providing incredible caregivers that are making sure that their loved ones, and I say the family's loved ones, are taking their medications on time, making sure that they're eating their meals, making sure they're getting up in the morning. Really, we're kind of an additional pair of hands and feet and eyes. We assist so many of our aging adult population be able to stay and remain at home. We're in our 22nd year. It's hard to believe it. When we started, there were less than 10 companies here in the Valley that did the type of work we do, and now we're talking about hundreds. But you know what? There's plenty of room for hundreds to be here because we have an aging demographic. So as I said at the top of the show, the secret to our show is bringing extraordinary guests that have, you know, a wealth of information and provide incredible services to our community. So today is no different, and I'm proud to bring two guests on the show. I've got one from outside of Arizona joining us, and I've got a gentleman that's been here in the Valley for a number of years and has developed a great reputation. So without further ado, I want to introduce our listening audience to Saul Blair, who is the Senior Vice President to IPC Healthcare. And I've also got Steve Smith, who's the Director of Business Development Post-Acute Care. And he's from the Kansas City region here joining us. Welcome, gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Well, I appreciate you guys being here. And, you know, I had a chance to meet Saul a couple years ago. And Saul, you know, what IPC and Saul Blair are doing in our community is really they're educating our healthcare professionals and educating them that, hey, you know what? The secret to success, and I met Saul through PATH. Would you explain to our listening audience a little bit about what PATH is?
Yes. PATH is post-acute transitional healthcare. And it is an opportunity for all of our healthcare providers in the Valley to come together and to start collaborating to provide quality of care to all patients in the Valley. Okay. What I discovered back in March of 2012, we have in healthcare a tremendous lack of communication and collaboration. Many of us are seeing the same patients, but many times we are not there at the same time when we are managing that one patient. managing a patient takes a team effort. And so I thought that it was important for me to put together the community and start working together and having educational programs to train and teach and exchange ideas on how to provide better care. I can say back in March, if this idea was about five people in my office sitting around having a conversation.
This was 2012?
2012. What drove this also is the Affordable Care Act, that many people didn't understand that the Affordable Care Act had penalties ingrained in it. And those penalties were primarily regarding readmissions. And hospitals were going to be penalized for readmitting patients within 30 days. So with that being said, you know, going forward today, we have a roster of over 700 people or organizations.
Providers
in the PATH program.
You know, it's really exciting for us. I mean, you know, Phoenix in a lot of ways and Arizona in a lot of ways is leading the charge in caring for our aging adult population because we have an aging demographic here. And I look at Saul Blair and IPC kind of being on the leading edge because in 2012, none of the other communities around in our country were really talking about this. And providers like Cypress and others have really embraced this because truly, you know, it's that old adage about, you know, what's the definition of insanity? You know, doing the same thing, expecting different results. And, you know, the Affordable Care Act, whether you are for it or against it or whatever, it really helped us to really pull back and really look at the way we deliver care. Mm-hmm. And Saul, I mean, you hit the nail on the head. Transitioning somebody from an acute setting, like a hospital setting or a rehab hospital setting, into the home is so critical. Mm-hmm. And it's not just critical in the initial transition, but the first 48 hours are huge. And, you know, we've talked about it here on the show, and you're welcome to, you know, share some facts and figures. But, I mean, a lot of times, and for our listening audience to hear this, a lot of times what's happening in the home is the reason why they are in those acute settings. And if we discharge them back to home and we're not in that home, home care providers like Cypress, transitionary care managers and companies like IPC leading the charge on that, they can end up right back into the hospital. You know, oftentimes we find that a lot of it is revolving around hoarders, people, you know, the house not being safe, maybe infestations that may be happening. But we also may find out that it's medication management. You know, it's very confusing for an aging adult person who gets discharged from a hospital or post-acute center. And they go home and they get these prescriptions. And, you know, a lot of the time, the case managers, you know, go through this whole list of things that they need to do. And if there's not somebody there with that aging adult person helping them decipher or ask the right questions, they go home, they get those prescriptions filled. And a lot of times, and I've seen it happen, where, okay, the patient that just got discharged is taking those two new prescriptions, but they weren't told not to take the other ones too.
You're absolutely right.
Medication management, I would imagine, is a big part of it, is it not, Saul?
It is a big part of it. At the same time, we have seniors who truly do not have transportation to pick up their medication. And we have to understand, we're talking about a wide range or educational level. So therefore, many seniors may not even understand how to read the package.
Interesting. And you know, with that, I mean, I think what we have done here, and you've led the charge, Saul, and I give you so much credit with creating this organization, Post-Acute Transitionary Healthcare PATH, and educating providers, but the providers are the ones that are going out into the community and educating the community at large to help them do that transition and help them understand what could be very difficult to understand for them, to try to simplify it, but also to stay in communication with them. You just can't drop them and go.
You're absolutely right. We can't drop them and go. But we do that in the healthcare system in the United States.
And we have a reputation of doing that. It's hard to believe it, Saul and Steve. We haven't really talked to you, Steve, but we're going to bring you in on the next segment. We're at the end of the first segment. You're listening to Health Futures Taking Stock in You. And I'm privileged to have Saul Blair and Steve Smith from IPC Healthcare talking about transitionary care. We will be right back.
This is Steve Phillips, owner of Z Cleaners, Arizona's only certified couture care specialist. You know, after dry cleaning, my favorite pastime is reading. No, not that novel. Reading our customer reviews. Here's one, the best I've dealt with. Oh, this is a good one. The most beautiful results you'll ever get. And my personal favorite, I live in Florida, yet I send my garments to you because I can't find a comparable cleaners anywhere in my state. Now that's what I call a bestseller. Give us a call today, 602-CLEANER. That's 602-CLEANER, Z-Cleaners, excellence always. Find us on the web, zcleaners.com. And remember, the most beautiful results you'll ever get. Call us today, 602-CLEANER.
Z-Cleaners protects your wardrobe investment with fail-safe methods for garment cleaning so that they last longer and look better. Their clients are professionals, decision-makers, and business owners like you who are experts in your fields. And Z-Cleaners is the garment care experts in the Phoenix area. Call today at 602-CLEANER. Congress has been busy, while in the news, with the budget, but behind closed doors, amendments to the budget that affect your retirement planning. Last December, it was turning the pension protection laws upside down. Then Friday, October 30th, it was stopping Social Security filing choices for all but a few. This has now changed the landscape of retirement planning. How will it affect you? Well, it all depends. When's your birthday? When will you be 66? Are you born in 1954 or later? If you aren't exactly sure how these new rules are impacting your retirement plan, then call Fleming Financial Services at 480-632-8770. That's 480-632-8770. Certified financial planner Nancy Fleming and her team will help you develop a plan to create a secure retirement for you. Otherwise, you may be in for a big surprise. By contacting Fleming Financial Services, you may be provided with information regarding the purchase of insurance or investment products.
Did you know Interstate Batteries is the nation's number one battery recycler of automotive batteries? You can learn more at interstatebatteries.com. Visit an Interstate Batteries dealer near you today.
Now back to Health Futures. Taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. My name is Bob Roth, and you're listening to Health Futures Taking Stock in You. If you're just tuning in, I've got two guests here in the studio. I got Saul Blair, and I got Steve Smith from IPC Healthcare. And if you're just tuning in, we're talking about transitions to home. We're talking about PATH, which is a great organization that IPC was on the leading edge in creating and helping get started here in the Valley. PATH stands for Post-Acute Transitionary Healthcare. And we're really talking about transitioning our aging adult population from an acute setting or a post-acute setting into the home. And, you know, when we talk about home, Saul, you know, most of people think of the house and the picket fence and they think of the sidewalk leading up to the house. But, you know, home can be in a number of different settings for our aging adult population.
You're absolutely right. I mean, patients are coming from everywhere. When we say the home, we're talking about group homes. We're talking about assisted living facilities. We're talking about independent facilities, okay? And in some cases, we're talking about homeless shelters.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to understand that when a patient is in that setting, there are multiple challenges as well.
And, you know, in those settings, as well as what I said in the first segment, the home setting, that could be a challenge itself too, especially if they're isolated and they're home alone. And one of the things that, you know, you and I have talked about in the past is that we've talked about the couples that are living together, our aging adult population. You know, they rely on one another, and we're talking about, you know, mainly the greatest generation, where they typically took the oath of sickness and health literally.
Mm-hmm.
and they don't want to be a burden to their kids, and they don't want to ask for help because they feel like they can do it all. And I've talked about it here on the show, and that, you know, especially when you have couples that are 65 and older, the biggest challenge that we have is that if they're not getting assistance from a home care company like ours, a home health care company, or somebody, a child, a neighbor, or a friend coming to help, 63% of the time, the caregiver predeceases the care recipient. And I'm talking about the family caregiver. It's really, really scary on what's going on. And we as a community really need to pull together. And one of the things that, you know, PATH has done and IPC has been leading the charge is pulling these providers. Like you said, we got over 700 providers at the table now, mm-hmm. talking about successfully transitioning someone from a acute size situation into the home and making sure that they can remain in home. Home may not be for everybody.
That's correct.
But our goal is to try to get them there. And, you know, one of the challenges that we have in our society today is that, you know, we talk about the adult children, but we also talk about money. And, you know, unfortunately, we have to have that conversation about money. And, you know, in these days and times, you know, with the economy the way it is, you know, if you don't have means and you don't have family members that can help you and you're not on the Medicaid plan, in our state we call it Access, you're in that middle, in that gray area. And Saul and Steve, I know you guys see it. I see it a lot, and it's very unfortunate. Now, I mean, while we've made some changes to how we're delivering care and how we're looking at it, we still have a long way to go.
No, you're absolutely right. The cost of health care and the fact that Medicare is cutting back, the out-of-pocket for our community and our patients is going to be much larger than what they can afford. I don't think today that our young people really are understanding long-term care. They're not understanding that the need for long-term care insurance is it needs to be an additional component on top of Medicare.
Mm-hmm.
We're not prepared. And today, for your services, for example, I am really annoyed that CMS or Medicare doesn't recognize the non-medical home care organization such as yours, because I see your organization really truly being a tremendous asset to the Medicare patient. Many patients get home, they can't cook, they don't understand the medication reconciliation. They can't get to the grocery store. They are just strictly homebound with no assistance. But at the same time, there aren't any benefits covering that. And then what happens? They're right back in the hospital. And then when you talk about diet, eating canned goods, large amounts of sodium, I really feel that the general public does not truly understand what is going on out there for our seniors in the home. People like myself and you, Bob, and Steve, we can navigate the healthcare system because we understand it. We have relationships. We can call people. But our everyday person has tremendous challenges. Even just going to the emergency room is a challenge. Even trying to get an appointment with their primary care doctor is a challenge. You know, you feel bad today, and the young lady says, I can't see you until 3 weeks from now. What alternative do you have but to go to the emergency room?
Yeah, you touched on one thing that I think is really important, and it's not only the financial obstacles and hurdles that people have to get through to get care. I think a big piece that's lacking and that I'm hopeful will improve over time is the educational aspect of everything. Mm-hmm. You mentioned, okay, I'm sick at home. I can't be seen for 3 weeks. What other avenues do I have to pursue? Is there another facility I can try to contact? And who is that facility and who's the person I need to contact at that facility? I know this is something we see in Kansas City. I'm sure it's prevalent here as well. And it's unfortunately one of the aspects of healthcare that currently in addition to the financial changes that we've seen and the structural changes that we've seen, it's a huge obstacle that not only the receivers of healthcare are going through, but the providers as well. As the regulations change, as the landscape changes, there has to be that increased communication to make sure that everybody's on the same page and really focusing on the well-being of the patient.
Absolutely. And I will tell you, we have to break the paradigm, because really where it comes into play is healthcare. Just the word healthcare is in our economy and the way we live in our communities, it's sick care. And Saul, you hit the nail on the head. You talk about diets and living a healthier life. Mm-hmm. You know, we really need to rethink about how we are managing our healthcare. I mean, we make choices. And unfortunately, the healthcare system is broken to the point where that people that are making bad choices is costing you mm-hmm. and I, and you too, Steve, a lot of money. Yeah. But if they made, you know, listen, some of us are predisposed genetically. You know, we're predisposed that we're going to have, whether it be diabetes or we're going to have something really bad happen to us, because it's going to affect our autoimmune system. And when it does, that switch is always turned on. But many of the problems that we have in our country, healthcare-wise, are because of decisions that consumers and members of our community make every day.
You know, that's another reason why PATH was started and formed. You find patients who need these services. And if my organization says we need a mobile physician program to come out to a patient that we are aware of that need, who is homebound but needs a physician to, or a nurse practitioner to go to the home, I now know who does what. I know what organization who is providing those services. I also sometimes find out which organizations do a good job. With that being said, I'm able to call that particular organization and say, look, I have a patient that I feel could use your services. Prior to PATH, I wasn't aware of that. And I will be honest, prior to PATH, I didn't have a lot of knowledge about non-medical home care.
And it's interesting you say that, because I want to talk about that, because my family's been running this business for 22 years. And as a result, we've been fabrics of the community for a long time. And invariably, I run into somebody that didn't really understand the work that we do. And I tell them about the work we do. And they're like, huh, I didn't know that. I wish I knew that when my mom was sick or my dad was sick. I didn't know those services were available. You know, this industry that you talk about, non-medical home care, is really only about 25 years old. It's relatively new. And that's part of the education. The other part, Saul, and I want to build on what you said, and we're going to come up on a break so we can pick up afterwards, is that we as a country need to recognize that this service is important and it's imperative in the transitionary care as well as ongoing care. And we've got to wake up and figure out how we're going to pay for this, because only those that have can pay. Mm-hmm. And as I said earlier, those that don't and that are on Medicaid can get services through Access. But I get phone calls every single day, and they ask me if Medicare will pay for the service or if their health plan will say pay for the service. And our conversation starts off with a negative, because I have to tell them we cannot. We're up against a break. Eric Clapton's taking us out. Saul Blair and Steve Smith from IPC Healthcare are with us. We'll be right back.
Special report, stocks and oil. U.S. stocks are sharply lower, but business correspondent Allison Kosick says don't be tempted to sell.
We are seeing the Dow below that 16,000 level, that psychological milestone. The Dow has lost more than 1,000 points in a matter of, let's say, a week and a half. It really is stunning when you think about it. But if you're an investor in this market, any financial analyst will tell you, sit tight and ride this out.
The Dow was down more than 500 points, a loss of more than 3% at one point today. And financial correspondent Christine Roman says the falling price of oil was a major reason why.
That's down 70% since its peak. That is a crash below $30 a barrel. That is such a good thing for drivers, for American consumers, such a bad thing for so many of the companies and so many of the financial products that are tied to crude oil.
The Dow down 473, the NASDAQ down 160, the S&P down 53. I'm Jim Ascendio.
This announcement is for every man tired of waking up multiple times a night to use the bathroom. By calling now, preferred customers can get a free bottle of GoFlo Prostate with ingredients shown to help reduce those annoying nighttime bathroom visits. The GoFlo Prostate Challenge is available by responding to this advertisement. If lines are busy, try again. Because the GoFlo Free Bottle Challenge is exclusive, it's not available in drugstores. GoFlo Prostate was formulated by Dr. Mitchell Fleischer with ingredients shown to support an aging prostate. GoFlo helps to increase flow when you go and helps to stop it when you sleep. We challenge you to try your first bottle of GoFlo absolutely free because we know you'll be amazed by the results. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-667-5348. That's 1-800-667-5348. This is a limited time offer. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-667-5348. That's 1-800-667-5348.
Hi, this is Don McDonald from Talking Real Money. I've been trying to help everyone in the Valley become a real investor since 1988. So what is a real investor? Well, real investing isn't gambling. It's not speculation. In fact, I've come to believe that even owning a few individual stocks is closer to gambling than investing. Real investing does not involve trying to predict the future. Real investing doesn't provide wealth without risk. Instead, it involves taking sound, scientifically based risk for your needs and personal tolerance. It's not hard to be a real investor, but you do need to unlearn some mistaken beliefs, as I have. On Saturday, January 23rd, I want to teach you what I've learned from Nobel Prize winners about real investing and how it can lead to a better retirement in my latest class, Real Retirement. Discount pre-sale tickets are available right now at TalkingRealMoney.com. To enjoy a really great retirement, you'll need a real investment portfolio, and I'll show you how to create one using no-load funds from Fidelity, Schwab, and Vanguard. Reserve your seats today at TalkingRealMoney.com. That's TalkingRealMoney.com.
This is Steve Phillips, owner of Z Cleaners, Arizona's only certified couture care specialist. You know, after dry cleaning, my favorite pastime is reading. No, not that novel. Reading our customer reviews. Here's one, the best I've dealt with. Oh, this is a good one. The most beautiful results you'll ever get. And my personal favorite, I live in Florida, yet I send my garments to you because I can't find a comparable cleaners anywhere in my state. Now that's what I call a bestseller. Give us a call today, 602-CLEANER. That's 602-CLEANER, Z Cleaners, excellence always. Find us on the web, zcleaners.com. And remember, the most beautiful results you'll ever get. Call us today, 602-CLEANER.
Z Cleaners protects your wardrobe investment with fail-safe methods for garment cleaning so that they last longer and look better. Their clients are professionals, decision makers, and business owners like you who are experts in your fields. And Z Cleaners is the garment care experts in the Phoenix area. Call today at 602-CLEANER.
I'm Bruce Vail with Your Money Now. Drug maker Merck has agreed to pay more than $830 million to settle a shareholder lawsuit that claimed the company misled shareholders by downplaying data regarding the risks associated with the painkiller Vioxx. Merck withdrew Vioxx from the market in 2004 after a study showed it increased the risk for heart attacks and strokes. Merck shares are down 2% today. Shares of poultry producers are being hit hard after an avian influenza outbreak was confirmed in Indiana. Some companies assured investors the outbreak didn't involve them, but their shares are down anyway. Shares of Tyson Foods are down nearly 3%. Sanderson Farms is down 7%. And shares of Pilgrim's Pride are down about 6%. The broader market is down sharply. The Dow Jones Industrial Average is down 432 points. The NASDAQ Composite is down 146. That's Your Money Now.
It's panic time. The boss just asked you when that new building will be completed, and you haven't even started yet. Well, don't panic. Call the name you know, General Steel. You've known General Steel for decades, and you know they'll save you about half the cost and about half the time of conventional construction. But did you know that General Steel has provided buildings for some of the biggest names in business and government? And did you know the General can provide pre-construction planning services for your total project? And I'll bet you didn't know you can get General Steel quality and save thousands. For example, a 40-foot by 60-foot building for under $22,000, or a 50 by 100 for under $35,000. That's right, 5,000 square feet for under $35,000. And all with General Steel's 50-year structural warranty. So don't panic. Call now and lock in some of the lowest prices this year. 866-95-STEEL. Call 866-95-STEEL today. Quick, the boss is coming. That's 866-957-8335.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. My name is Bob Roth, and you're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you missed our first two segments, you can find them up on our website at cypresshomecare.com. There's a top on the very, very top, there's a radio button. There's one midway down. You can catch this segment and the first two segments of this show, as well as you can catch about 85 to 90 others on our website that we've been bringing to you for now 3 years. We're in our third year. So if you're just tuning in, I've got Saul Blair, I've got Steve Smith from IPC Healthcare. We were talking about the word healthcare and how it really is sick care, and really how we need to really be mindful of promoting better health. And more than that, we've been talking about transitionary care. And Saul, we talked about PATH, but we really haven't talked about IPC. And I really would like you to share with our listening audience what IPC is. What do you guys do in our community? Because you do a lot. You do a lot to help, really, to improve outcomes for the patients that are in the hospital setting.
Well, Bob, you're right. We do a lot. Some days I can't keep up with what we do, but we do a lot. First of all, in general, we are a hospitalist company, and we provide medical care to patients who are in the hospital. We don't have an outpatient practice on the most part. The patients cannot dial our office number and make an appointment to see a physician. Patients who are admitted into the hospital from the emergency room, they're put on our service and so we're the managing provider for inpatient services. But then you take it another step further. We have contracts with payers, i.e. United Health, Banner Health, Network, multiple. So we see their patients as well. But since I started IPC in 1998, we have also transitioned into the post-acute. So in other words, I was seeing patients who were leaving the acute setting, but we were not managing those patients in the post-acute setting, post-acute being in the skilled nursing facilities. So now we are in that business as well. We are doing assisted living visits to residents in some markets in our company. But I've also expanded in our business to infectious disease. We have wound care specialists. But for the Phoenix regions, we also have pediatricians. We are the hospitalist group for Banner Cardinals Medical Center, which is their children's hospital. So with that being said, that primarily in a nutshell. But I also felt we cannot be in a community as a business and not service the business in multiple ways. And I think PATH was one of the ways to service the community. We have to figure out how to provide better quality care. We hear that everywhere, quality of care.
Mm-hmm.
But we're not diving deep, as I always say, diving into the weeds and identifying where the gaps are in quality of care and defining or developing systems and processes to change those gaps, improve those gaps in healthcare. And that's a challenge, but we're not done.
Well, and especially when you're dealing with healthcare that is a moving target. It's changing every day. And as you described IPC, I envision you really being more of a quarterback, a coordinator, a facilitator for those patients with all the different entities and providers that come into play to ensure that there are great outcomes in those acute settings as well as post-acute settings.
You're absolutely right. I mean, it's funny. I use the word quarterback in amongst my team and in my office a lot, but we do have a quarterback, and the quarterback that we have is what we call our patient care coordinator, and she's an RN,
mm-hmm.
and she's out and about, and she's interacting with our providers, our doctors, our nurse practitioners, and identifying patients who need extensive care, but extensive care once they're discharged. She's reaching out to home health. She's reaching out to organizations such as yours and saying, I have a patient that we need to extend further care to. Okay. So, yes, I really feel IPC should have a quarterback. My wish list is to have this quarterback in the near future in the hospital, on the floors, working with the hospitalist and identifying patients' needs beyond the hospital. I want to say one thing, and that is two things, matter of fact. When I started my master's program and in my first class in healthcare administration, our professor challenged us, and he asked a question, and he started a debate. And he asked one simple question, is healthcare a privilege or is it a right? And it's very interesting that I never will forget that day that the class, the students, was divided straight down the middle.
And I figured it would.
And it was a heated argument. Okay? But it's interesting because the haves feel it's a privilege. But the have-nots feel it's a right. People who've never had anything feel, hey, I have the right to have health care. So that was interesting. So, and then the other day I was in a meeting with a group of emergency room doctors, probably about 13 of them throughout the valley. We were having a discussion. And a physician said, you know, we send patients out of the emergency room. We send patients out of the hospital. But in reality, we're just throwing them over the wall. And we have no idea what happens to them next. I thought that was a powerful statement for physicians to say, we're throwing them over the wall.
You know, it's interesting. You know, I want to go back to your statement in your master's program about the ones that have not and one that have versus, you know, it's a right or it's a privilege. You know, I think that microcosm really expands into our country. And really that's really where we're at right now. And it's, you know, we really don't, you know, advocate discussing politics here on our show, but we're talking about the challenges that we deal with as a society.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that in itself is something that we really need to dive into and really help our communities understand whether it's a privilege or a right. I mean, healthcare is something that you need to take control over. You know, you can't, and I know this, and I've had many guests on this, and I'm going to say that the two of you subscribe to this, you know, You shouldn't have somebody else in charge of your health care. You've got to be in control of that. And if you get sick, you need to find relief. You need to find out what the issues are. You need to do your research. You need to be empowered to make those decisions. And I think a lot of challenges, people are just expecting that, you know, hey, you know what, I'll go to the doctor. He'll tell me what to do. Well, you know what, he or she may tell you, but you may not be happy with that. And it's incumbent upon you to do your research. And if you're not happy with what they're telling you to do, get a second opinion. Get a third opinion. Figure out what is the best solution for you. You know, it's hard to believe we're coming up on another break. You know, I told you, Saul, when we started this, I said, you know, we can't do this in just one show. Because, you know, I want to talk about, you know, what you said about the ER docs throwing the patient over the wall. And I want to talk about how we can transition them. And I think PATH is one of the ways of doing that. But two, I want to talk about the future of healthcare. So with that, we're on a break. We got our fourth segment coming up. You're listening to Health Futures. We'll be right back.
Today, investing feels scary. Hi, I'm Don McDonald from Talking Real Money. Stocks have been plummeting, bonds scare you, but do you really know what kind of risk you have in your portfolio? I bet you don't. While you must take risk to make money investing, anyone who claims otherwise is lying, you need to understand risk and know exactly how much risk lurks in your portfolio. Then, you need to learn how to build the right portfolio for your needs and risk tolerance. Most of what we save and invest is for our retirement, so our future lives literally depend on how we invest today. That's why I created a valuable real class, not a sales seminar, called Real Retirement, and I hope you'll attend my next one on January 23rd in Scottsdale. Tickets are on sale now at TalkingRealMoney.com. Learn all about risk and how to manage it by creating a portfolio based on Nobel Prize-winning research. Over 1,200 people paid to take my class in 2015, and now it's your turn. Reserve your seats today at TalkingRealMoney.com, TalkingRealMoney.com.
The largest wealth and passive income expo in the country is coming to Texas Saturday, February 6th. Join thousands of top investors and expert wealth educators. Pick from 60-plus topics: retirement, passive income, asset protection, tax-free income, finding, fixing, and funding single and multifamily investments. Get your path to retirement in just one day. Go to wealthandpassiveincomeexpo.com. Gain one-on-one access to hundreds of industry experts, realtors, lenders, property and asset managers, apartment owners, real estate syndication, and trade professionals. Come shake hands with your retirement partner. Use promo code NOW and get VIP access. Tickets to the expo are only $49. Use promo code NOW and get $10 off. Bring a guest and get VIP seating. WealthandPassiveIncomeExpo.com. Your path to retirement in just one day. WealthandPassiveIncomeExpo.com. Use promo code NOW.
LiveWatch helps you connect and respond up to 10 times faster in an emergency. LiveWatch has no long-term contracts. Save up to 50% off home security. Call 855-LiveWatch or visit livewatch.com.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. My name is Bob Roth, and you're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. And if you're just tuning in, we're in our last segment. And I've got IPC Healthcare. I've got Saul Blair, who's the Senior Vice President right here in our market. I've got Steve Smith, Director of Business Development for Post-Acute Care in the Kansas City region here. And we've been talking a lot about where healthcare is and where it's going. And, you know, one of the things that we left off on our last segment, we were talking about, you know, patients being in control of their healthcare. And, you know, we've had this conversation here on our show about having the conversation. And I'm specifically talking about families, adult children, talking to their parents about how they would like to live out their life. And when end of life comes, how would they like to see it? Because a lot of people are afraid to have this conversation. They don't have this conversation. It's really, really important. And I think that really dovetails into the fact that, you know, we as consumers of healthcare need to be, you know, really astute enough to ask questions and not look at our doctors who give us, you know, a prescription and whatever that prescription is, whether it be medication, whether it be a treatment protocol, whatever that is, to continue to ask questions, and if they're not happy with it, to get second or third opinions. You know, Steve, I'd love for you to share some insight on that.
Yeah, you know, one of the things that you had alluded to earlier and that we've kind of touched on throughout the show has been a paradigm shift that has to take place. We're no longer in an era where my physician has said this, therefore I will do this.
Right.
The receivers of healthcare, the patients and the residents, they don't it's not only that they have to be willing to ask those questions, but they or their family members or other caregivers need to make sure they feel empowered to do so, because it is important. They are the ones that, at the end of the day, are going to be responsible for implementing whatever care plan has been decided. And if there's an issue of, you know, maybe they're not comfortable with a certain aspect of that care plan, whether it be medication or, you know, the amount of physical therapy that they're going to receive or the schedule in which they're going to receive it, or even if they're going to an assisted living facility or a post-acute facility, making sure it's the facility they want to go to. It's convenient to their home. They're satisfied with the metrics and the outcomes that that facility has presented in the past. They need to be not only involved, but really the drivers of some of those decisions. And like I said, really be empowered to be a driver.
And you know what's interesting is, Steve and Saul, there's so much information that's available at our fingertips. And, you know, lots of doctors will tell their patients, especially when they get a not-so-good diagnosis, to really kind of stay off the Internet, because there's a lot of bad information there too. But, you know, if you zero in and look for the right resources, you can get some of the stuff that you're looking for to
sure.
make an informed decision.
Sure.
And at the end of the day, that's what you want to do.
Absolutely. And even if they're not comfortable because they may have some hesitation on finding that information online, there is no harm in getting a second opinion. The physician who had the initial diagnosis or plan of treatment isn't going to feel slighted or, you know, insulted that you want to have that second opinion.
Right.
It's not going to impact your future care. It's just your right and really your responsibility as the receiver of quality health care to make sure that you not only have an understanding, but that you're completely comfortable with what that plan is going to be.
And I want our listening audience to take that away. It's just, you know, the old adage, especially the adult children that are listening in, and, you know, they listen to their mom or dad saying, well, the doctor said this. You know, oftentimes we're talking about an aging adult population, and if somebody's in their 80s or 90s, you know, they may not have dementia, but then again, they may, and there's a high incidence for them to have it, but they also don't have the memory recall that somebody that is 40, 50, or 60 might. So, you know, they don't necessarily understand what those orders are. So I encourage our adult children out there to accompany their parents and loved ones. And if they can't, maybe have a surrogate go in there. And there's, you know, geriatric care managers that are in markets, or there are other resources out there that can accompany them so they can ask the questions, but at the same time, gather the data back so they can make an informed decision.
Absolutely. You know, one of the things I've heard Saul say time and time again, and it's absolutely right, is anytime that we're looking at healthcare, we have to consider where does the patient fit. If we're not taking that in consideration, we're not going to get the outcomes that we need to have.
Right. Right. Oh, absolutely. You know, Saul, you said something at the end of the last segment that is quite disturbing, and I would imagine it is to many of our listening audience too, and that is, you know, those 13 ER docs that you had together mm-hmm. where, you know, they made the comment that they feel like they're throwing the patients over the wall. You know, I had a conversation with a post-acute rehab hospital just recently, mm-hmm. and, you know, many of our listening audience don't know this, but in the healthcare world, as a part of the Affordable Care Act, hospitals have been managed as it relates to readmissions. And this year, 2016, post-acute centers are now too. And it's interesting because when I asked this post-acute hospital, because they made a discharge to a not a very worthy home care solution. I said, what are you guys doing to follow up? Is anybody making calls, quality calls, to see how the patients are doing? She said, no, nobody's doing that. And you know what? Until that happens, and Saul, I give you kudos, bravo, for helping create PATH so that we can have this conversation. And 700 providers now are in tune with, instead of throwing that person over the wall, we're all singing from the same sheet saying, hey, you know what? We need to transition these people. The first 48 hours are critical. And you know what? The next 20 to 30 days are really critical. And I'm trying to help these post-acute units understand why home care makes a lot of sense. And, you know, now that they are going to potentially be dinged or shared savings, you know, home care could be a good solution for those that are in the middle that don't have. Mm-hmm. And who's going to pay for it? And I'm telling them they need to. Mm-hmm. They need to subsidize it. They're doing it in other markets, and they're very successful. They're doing it with hospitals, and post-acutes are doing it where, you know, it's much easier to spend $150 or $200 a day for 20 days or 30 days versus, you know, seeing a couple $100,000 ding for that one patient because they went back in. I think we need to shift this paradigm. It's kind of like an aircraft carrier that, you know, we're not in a speedboat where we can turn it around really easily. You know, you got to take that aircraft carrier out about 200 miles or maybe 20 miles, whatever it is, and you got to slowly turn it around. I mean, unfortunately, that's what we're doing. We're turning an aircraft carrier. We're not turning a speedboat.
Well, you're absolutely right, because I always say one thing. What I'm trying to do through PATH and IPC is row the Titanic with one oar, okay? And it's a challenge. But the other part of it, let's understand that when someone says we're throwing a patient over the wall, for me, it doesn't stop there. What he told me was, Saul, we're throwing them over the wall. And what I found out is, Saul, it's your responsibility to change that. So I am now circling back to the group. We had a very good discussion. We're putting together a communication plan as to how to call providers and saying, I'm sending a patient to you. And for that provider to say, I'm accepting your patient by And the ER doctor and the post-acute provider now will start talking to each other. That now, yes, you're putting them over the wall, but there's someone there to catch them.
Got it.
Okay. So you have to show me or convince me why we can't do something right.
Well, I think, you know, for you to do that, especially here in our community, is a start. And unfortunately, it's going to be a process. Mm-hmm. And it's an education. You know, we've run a lot of different discussions in our show here today. You know, I want to just give a quick call out to our listening audience. If you want to talk to Saul about the great work that IPC Healthcare is doing here, and they're improving patient care is their motto, you can reach him at 602-789-0344. Or you can go to ipchealthcare.com. So, you know, the future, you know, many people might say it looks bleak. For me, it's organizations like IPC. It's organizations like PATH that you helped to create. It's going to make healthcare much better in our community. And hopefully it makes it happen faster than slower. Guys, I really appreciate you being here. We're up against the end of the show. IPC Healthcare, thank you, Saul.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Make it a great day. Have a great weekend.
Thank you.
There's no place like home. You've been listening to Bob Roth's Health Futures. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call Cypress Home Care Solutions at 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Or visit cypresshomecare.com. Be sure to join Health Futures with Bob Roth every Friday at noon, right here on Money Radio 1510 and 99.3 FM.
Hi, I'm Corey Scheiler, owner of Core Fitness. My team of certified personal trainers want to help you look great and get into great shape. We'll listen to your needs and develop a tailored workout that will get you results. We help our clients lose weight, improve their balance, get stronger, and feel awesome. You will have more confidence whether out in the town or playing your favorite sport. You can try us out for 21 days for $21. Call us at 480-620-3000. Email us at Corey, C-O-R-Y, at corefitnessaz.com.
Money Radio 1510 and 99.3 FM
is KFNN Mesa Phoenix and K257 CB Phoenix. Tap into the modern technology of your smart device. Download the Money Radio app and you'll have us with you no matter where you go. Bad day for the markets. Dow down 357 points, NASDAQ down 119, the S&P is down 38 points.
When people want to talk about money, this is the place they come to. And there's more on the way after this break for the latest news. And we begin now.